today we're gonna replace the oil filter and air filter on my 2010 Honda Civic Hybrid. So here we are inside the driver's seat. I'm gonna go ahead and start the car to show you guys. When you need to do some maintenance, like the oil life, you notice we're not at 50%, but it looks like that light comes on. This means maintenance is required, the little wrench. Right now I'm guessing it's at 15% when it usually triggers it. I usually recommend doing it a little bit before, maybe like 20%, which you could look at when you go through the screens. If you hit select reset over here on the left side of the steering wheel, it'll change it back to the odometer and then that light will go away. But make sure you don't ignore it. You want to change your oil at the proper intervals, which looks like right now the car's saying that we need to do it. So we'll go ahead and get that started right now. First thing we're going to go ahead and do is get the car in ramps. Have it face down on the driveway, so when it gets onto the ramp, it's going to be pretty close to level. Got it up. Got the parking brake on. Just going to chalk off the back wheels. So getting under the car here, what I wanted to show you is that we have this like splash guard that we're gonna have to remove. It's held on by a couple clips, which I took a look and some of them are actually missing. Should be one right here, it's gone. There should be one right here, it's gone. There's one right here, which is holding this cover, which is where the engine drain plug is at. There's a couple at the other end. So I have this clip removal tool. Again, we just need to take this one off, so I'm not gonna worry about any of these. I do need this one right here though to come off. I definitely did that wrong. So with that panel out of the way, you see it's still up here hanging out from the top. You can get a good look at the oil pan. Here's the oil filter. We're going to be replacing that too, but we're going to start by draining the oil from the oil drain plug over here. So coming from behind the passenger side wheel here, you see the cover is just hanging down here. The way we're going to remove it is there's actually some clips. There's five of them. One right here, same two on the other side, and then one in the middle. We're just going to remove it, and then this whole cover should actually just drop down. That will let us be able to get it out of the way so that we could go ahead and start draining the oil. I'm not going to be able to get a super good shot of it, but the way that you remove this is kind of just try to lift up that centerpiece.
I have some extras just in case. I want to see if I can try to reuse these.
There we go. Just get this in like this. Pull it out and it just comes right out. I removed two on the other side already, so about three more of these to do, and then we'll go ahead and get this cover off. So on the last clip here, the one in the middle.
What we gotta do is just lift it up from the center, the same type of clip as all five of the other ones from the back. Just wanna make sure you're not over-pulling it, because you don't want to break off the centerpiece, so we're gonna pull it from. Then lift it, and
pull it down like this. Got all the clips out, so now we can remove this splash cover. Gonna go ahead and do is we're gonna go under the car here. So here we are under the car. I got the oil pan here ready for the bolt to come off. So what we're gonna go ahead and do is just get this on. It's a 17 millimeter, I believe. Yeah, 17 millimeter. I'm gonna go ahead and crack it loose. So we're gonna let that drain. We'll leave this over here. It has a little magnet for the nut.
Now we're gonna come over the top of the car.
Just gonna remove the oil fill cap. Let all the air go in there.
let the oil flow.
Well, to the bottom over here. It's already actually already starting to slow down. This car doesn't hold a ton of oil, but we're gonna let that drain for a little bit, and then we're gonna remove the oil filter next. So next thing we're gonna do, now that it's starting to drip very little, let's go ahead close over here, so we can have it right under where this oil filter is. She wants to invite you somewhere. Actually just got this oil pan. I love it because it has this little spot for the filter, a spot for the plug over there, and then it just drains into here. I'll give it a wipe with the towel before I close it up, and then just go ahead and take it to recycle the oil. I'm just gonna let this drain for a little bit longer. I'm gonna prep the new filter, and then we'll go ahead and start getting it installed. Now what I'm gonna go ahead and do is prep the new oil filter. See it compared to the old filter, pretty much the same. This one's actually from Honda. What's up? It's not a big filter, so you don't need too much. Well, that absorbs it. Just gonna take some of it and lubricate the gasket O-ring around the edge, so that when we install it, it doesn't bend or fold. So here we are again, back into the car. It's pretty much not dripping anything anymore. I'm pretty sure we got all the oil that we're gonna get, but I have the drain plug here. So what we're gonna do is just thread it on.
I'm gonna set it in my hand, make sure it's going easily, so you don't strip the threads. It doesn't have to be super tight at all.
Got the crush washer in there, you see between. You want to make sure yours is in good condition, which mine was, so I was able to reuse it. One more check. It's perfect. So we're under again. The drain plug you're gonna see is gonna be over here. The opposite side of the pan is where the filter is. So what we're gonna do is just gonna line it up with the threads up here. I have this pretty full, it's a little crooked, so it might spill a little bit, but it should be okay for the most part.
I said I have the plug, you want to make sure it's going on easily and going straight, you don't mess up any of the threads. You should actually cut on already. I'm gonna push it, it's gonna spin it, but it'll go up on its own. If it's smoothed up, it's gonna slow down, so it's gonna give it a closer twist. It doesn't have to be any tighter than what you get from your hand. Like the material of this filter actually gives it a good grip. Turn.
That's plenty right there. So we got the new oil filter on, it's pre-filled with oil. We got the drain plug back on. This car's empty of oil right now except for the filter, so we're gonna just fill it back up. Take your measurement, make sure it looks good, run the oil for a little bit, and then make sure there's no leaks. So we're at the top of the car, in the engine bay. You can see the oil fills right here, so I'm just gonna funnel in. There's a little cover or something in there that kind of doesn't let it sit all the way.
Should've been at 1.6, it's pretty close to 1.5. And this is with the filter that I'm supposed to have 3.4, so I pre-filled that, so I should be left with 1.5 in this bottle, the 5 quart.
The oil fill cap back on. Now that we got the oil done really quickly, we're gonna go ahead and replace the air filter too. So in this car, it's got four clips, two on each side.
Push them down.
Look at that. So that's the old one. Should probably have worn gloves. Here we have the new one. Let's see them side by side. So now we're gonna go ahead and install the new filter. Just want to make sure when you install it, this little tab is up, because it does have this groove right here, which only fits in the top right corner, so it should be in the top left here. Box should feel pretty good. That's one, two, three. I did disconnect this master flow sensor, so I'm just gonna plug that back in. Clicks. It should be connected. So now that we got the oil filled up, the last thing to do is just put this cover on. Like I said earlier, some of them were missing and I did break one of them. So I went ahead and I got a kit not too long ago that has spares. So what we're gonna do is just get this cover aligned and put it back on. I'll try to give you guys the best view I can. It's just kind of hard because it's not a lot of space. So now that we got the oil change, what we're gonna do is turn the car on. We're actually gonna push and hold this select reset button. What this is gonna do is make the oil light start flashing. It's about 10 seconds. It's gonna start flashing, we let it go, and then we're gonna push and hold it for 5 seconds. And then it switches to the odometer, and what we do is now turn the car off, turn it back on. You'll see right away before when we started the car, the maintenance lights was on. You see that's gone now. If I go through the switches, you'll see now that the oil life is at 100%. So now the oil change is done. Just want to make sure as you drive around, check to see if you see any leaks from the bottom. Make sure that you check your oil level every now and then. Make sure it's topped off to the right where it should be, and we should be good to go.